This podcast is sponsored by Cloud Optimizer.
As we migrated more of our business to the cloud, we were seeing expenses go up, but we couldn't pinpoint the cause. It seemed less of a cloud, more of a fog. That's why we brought on Cloud Optimizer, and they saved the day.
Are you seeing your cloud hosting bills go up and you're not sure why? It's time to put Cloud Optimizer to work for you. Cloud Optimizer analyzes usage patterns, right-sizes resources, leverages discounts you may not be aware of, implements automation, and much more. And by reducing unnecessary expenses and maximizing performance, Cloud Optimizer guarantees you a savings of 5 times what you spend for their service.
With Cloud Optimizer, we have our spend under control, our company is more agile, profitable, and we're getting peak performance from our cloud.
Make the cloud work for you with Cloud Optimizer. Get a free assessment and find out how much you can save by going to cloudoptimizer.com. Go to cloudoptimizer.com for your free assessment. That's cloudoptimizer.com.
WBSM presents The Tim Weisberg Show, streaming live on WBSM.com and the WBSM app. Call 508-996-0500. Send us app chat messages and open line voicemails using the WBSM app. Now, The Tim Weisberg Show.
Welcome back in hour number three of the program here on Wednesday morning. And yes, it is May. The Justin Timberlake memes are starting to come out. And the carnival starts tomorrow night. Hold on 1 second. Just trying to get some information for you. The carnival starts tomorrow night. It will be on the front side of the mall between Taco Bell and Buffalo Wild Wings. And I'm working on a story that I should have up a little bit later on today about something that will be part of the carnival that wasn't there last year. Those of you who went know what I'm talking about, but I'm going to hold off. And the new policy will certainly be there. That will be in effect. And that's still got people divided. I was checking out some of the comments during the news, and people are still commenting about it and still seems 50-50 to me. People who think this is a good idea to keep underage kids out of the carnival unless they have adult supervision, and other people that are like, what is the point of having a carnival if teenagers can't go and have a good time with their friends? And listen, I'm not trying to bash the carnival, but when I went last year, and again, I didn't quote unquote attend, I paid $5 to get in so I could walk around, take photos and notes for a story I was writing about the neighbors complaining about the noise. So I was there walking around amongst the people, but I wasn't enjoying the carnival, so to speak. And as I was walking around, one of the things that I noticed is there were far more adult rides than there were kiddie rides. I don't know that that carnival, at least in the rides that were sent last year, and Fiesta Shows usually operates a couple of shows every weekend in different places, so they're dividing up their rides. But I didn't see a whole ton of kids' rides, maybe like 3 or 4, and maybe like 8 or 10 adult rides. And I'm just guessing here. I could probably go through the photo gallery that we have on our stories, but that's just, you know, off the top of my head. So it's not like this is something that people are rushing to bring young kids anyway. If you are looking for a place to bring young kids to, by the way, not that I'm saying you should forego the carnival, because that's this weekend and this event isn't happening until August, but I just don't think I mentioned it on the air. Thomas the Tank Engine is returning to Edaville. They're bringing back Day Out with Thomas. So we have the story on our website, but if you go to Edaville's site, you can get tickets to that. But, you know, just for the young kids who are Thomas obsessed and haven't been able to enjoy Thomas at Edaville for the last couple of years, he'll be back. He'll be back for a visit this year. But getting back to the Dartmouth Carnival, I think that there's a lot of, you know, there's more adult rides. The Ferris wheel. Oh, yeah, I guess the giant slide is for all ages. But the roundup, you know, the thing where you stand there. I used to call it the mummy cages when I was a kid. Because you stood there like in a coffin. And then it spins around and goes up on its side. And you know what I'm talking about? It's like the Gravitron, except outdoors. And the Gravitron's still my all-time favorite ride. But the rides seem more geared toward older kids and adults. So you would think it would be a place where a group of teenagers want to go and meet up with their friends. A group of 17-year-olds. Like when I was 17 and we would go to Fairhaven, we'd go to Bowler's Country Club across the street here. We'd go to Pockets, which was in this plaza where the liquor store is now. Play pool. You know, just 17-year-old kids looking to go somewhere and have some fun and maybe go on a date. Not cause trouble. I'm trying to think. We didn't really have any carnivals regularly when I was a teenager. We did later on, they did bring one to the old Walmart parking lot in Wareham, but I don't remember there being one when I was in high school that everybody went to. Maybe the Barnstable County Fair, but that was in the summertime. But anyway, kids want to go and hang out at something like this with their friends and not with their parents, and they will come and spend money. 17-year-olds that have a job or have parents that will give them money have money to spend and will think nothing of going there and spending all that money, whether it be on rides or games or what have you. So I think that Fiesta Shows is well aware of this, and obviously they've been in business for a long time. They know who their customers are. They know who the clientele is, but they're willing to make this sacrifice because of the issues that have happened. So it will be interesting to see who turns out for the carnival this weekend. And, you know, it may be a little bit different the first couple of nights. People might be against this policy and decide not to go. But then by, you know, the second week or next weekend, they might say, yeah, you know what? I found another adult that'll come with me and the kids, or, you know, it's not that big of a deal anymore. And maybe any negative feelings they had about it will go away once they get there and they realize it's not as bad as they thought, or maybe for the best. Now, tomorrow night, it's going to be a little chilly out. It'll be partly cloudy skies, but it's going to be 46 degrees. So that might limit some of the attendance at the carnival. And then on Friday, it's going to be 40 degrees at night again. Just taking a look at the weather for the next couple of days. Saturday night, 44 with increasing clouds and showers, because you know it had to rain, but that'll be after midnight. Sunday, it's going to be raining throughout the day and into the night. So you're going to have some chilly but decent weather for the most part for this first opening weekend of the carnival. Next week, there's, you know, Wednesday and Thursday, it's going to rain. And then next weekend, Saturday and Sunday, it looks like it might rain. So you might not be, and it's raining right now, by the way. So you might not be getting families coming out on some of those days. But who would come out? Teenagers. Teenagers who don't care if it's cold or don't care if it's raining. They just want to go to the carnival with their friends. But Fiesta Shows is aware of this, and they're still put this policy in place. So they believe they're doing the right thing or they're doing the required thing, one way or the other. I really want to see if I can get somebody from Fiesta Shows to pop on the show tomorrow and talk about it. And maybe answer some questions from you, the audience. But we can talk more about that. People are still upset about it. People are still complaining about it. The comments still keep rolling in. 508-996-0500. Also, I want to remind everybody, too, that because it is Wednesday, today will be midweek with the mayor, with Chris, during South Coast Now in the 11 o'clock hour. And he has a bunch of questions he has for Mayor Mitchell about many things going on in the city, but I know he wants to find out more about that retirement board meeting and the open meeting law violation. I know he has more questions about the CPA funding. So it'll be a very interesting discussion. Maybe Mayor Mitchell will talk some more about the decision to reopen the Buttonwood Park Senior Center, to put the senior programming back at Buttonwood Park after moving it out of there about a year ago. And of course, the mayor will take your calls at 508-996-0500 coming up in the 11 o'clock hour. He'll probably also want to mention the new athletic fields at New Bedford High, which you can read about at WBSM.com and on the app. Ariel was there yesterday for the ribbon cutting of the new fields, the new turf fields for the lacrosse and field hockey teams. And as I was saying earlier, this isn't, you know, the turf that people worried about 20, 25 years ago that would cause injuries. This is a more natural turf. This is the type of turf that they use now at NFL stadiums like Gillette Stadium. Speaking of Gillette Stadium, tomorrow tickets go on sale for the special Tom Brady Patriots Hall of Fame event. Ticket sales start at $100. They're going to be very limited. They go on sale tomorrow and they're going to sell out quick. So if you want to try to get them, I would recommend getting there early. Getting online early and refreshing again and again and again. And speaking of Gillette Stadium, the end of the month, the Rolling Stones will be there. And Gillette put out a press release the other day that I found was very interesting. We are talking about the 100th concert to happen at Gillette Stadium since it opened. Will happen on May 30th, the 100th concert. And who is the act in that 100th concert? The same band that was the first concert that performed at Gillette Stadium, the Rolling Stones. And if you had said to me in 2002, when Gillette Stadium opened up and the Rolling Stones played, if you had said to me, and 100 concerts from now, the Rolling Stones will be the band that plays, I would have said, there's no way. There's no way the Rolling Stones make it another 20 years as a band, as a touring band, but here we are. Just put out a new album last year and got great reviews, and I liked it. I thought it was good. And of course, they're down Charlie Watts, but still, they're out there and they're performing, and they're going to be the 100th concert at Gillette Stadium, so if the Rolling Stones are anything, they are certainly, what's the word I'm looking for? Timeless. Mick Jagger still running around the way he did 30 years ago. 508-996-0500. I also have a story that I mentioned earlier. You can check it out at WBSM.com and on the app. But I wrote this story yesterday because, you know, I was saying to Phil Devitt, who is also our digital managing editor here, you know, I don't think anybody's ever written about William Mumler, the spirit photographer from Boston, the guy who allegedly took pictures of ghosts. And while most people feel now that Mumler's work was a hoax, the interesting thing is nobody can really quite explain exactly how he did it. But he would have people come and sit for a photo. He would warn them ahead of time. You may or may not get a spirit in this photo. And then they would sit for their portrait, which at the time cost about $2 to have somebody have their portrait taken. But Mumler charged $10 to take a spirit photo. And then maybe a deceased loved one would show up in the photo. Now, in these photos, which you can see examples of in the story, these people are sitting there and somebody shows up behind them. And they would say, oh my gosh, that's my Uncle Chester who died 20 years ago. And we're talking about the 1860s, 1870s. So was there a photo of Uncle Chester? Probably not. So is it just a double exposure of an Uncle Chester photo? P.T. Barnum accused Mumler of breaking into people's homes and stealing photos of their relatives to use as ghosts in their spirit photos. And they were getting people in these photos that there never was a photo of. So is it that, or is it more the power of suggestion that they saw a ghostly figure and they said, oh, that must be Uncle Frank. Or, gee, that kind of looks like Uncle Frank. Or they wanted Uncle Frank to show up in the photo so badly that they saw a figure show up and that must have been Uncle Frank. And that's something that I deal with in paranormal investigation and research all the time, where people want it to be somebody so badly that every little thing that happens becomes that person. So you desperately want to, you know, make peace with your mother who died before you could bury the hatchet between the two of you. And so now everything that happens to you is your mother reaching out. You know, you could be walking by and a mug falls off the table. Oh, my mother knocked that off. You know, like people start to ascribe paranormal rationale to things that might not necessarily require it. And sometimes as a person who does what I do, you have to learn to just stand back and say, oh, okay. Like one of the big controversies are orbs. These orbs that show up in photos, which most of the time are just dust or moisture or bugs reflecting back into the lens and making these orbs of kind of light appear in these photos. And a lot of people are convinced that it's ghosts, but 99.9% of them can be explained away. But when somebody, you know, my friend Jeff Belanger taught me, when somebody's showing you a picture of an orb and you're like, what do you think? And you say, well, it could be dust or a bug or moisture. And they say, no, that's my Aunt Mary. You have to just nod and say, oh, okay. Yeah. Wow. It's nice that she came back for you. Because that person's convinced it's Aunt Mary no matter what you're going to tell them. And two, you really don't know for sure that it is an Aunt Mary. You weren't there. You can't say that it definitely was a bug or whatever. So I don't know. I do think it's a little bit dangerous sometimes to play into people's delusions, but I also have, and I argue about this with my psychic medium friend, Stephanie Burke, but I also think if it helps people get closure and get over their grief, I don't mind just nodding and smiling and saying, oh yeah, I can see that. Anyway, 508-996-0500. You can read about Mumler and see some examples of his spirit photography at WBSM.com and on the WBSM app. We'll be right back. That goes out to Aaron, who sent an app chat message saying, you played the Smiths, now do Joy Division. So there you go. There's some Joy Division for you. And while love will never tear us apart again, we won't let the news do that to us either, right? Here at WBSM, we all can disagree on things. We all can have different perspectives, but we will all come together and talk about it like adults. And if you don't, I'll scream at you and hang up on you. At least that's what everybody says that I do. Anyway, speaking of the news, it is time to get it all with Phil Devitt in the WBSM newsroom.
Columbia University protesters could face charges. A Trump lawyer says the former president was behind an alleged hush money deal. And job worries for American workers.
From the WBSM newsroom, this is WBSM News.
Police are sorting out a large number of arrests after they cleared out a building at Columbia University overnight that was taken over by pro-Palestinian protesters. New York City Mayor Eric Adams says the NYPD and Columbia identified a substantial number of people who took over Hamilton Hall as outside influencers and agitators mixed with students.
There was no way I was going to allow those children to be exploited the way they were being exploited. And many people thought that this was just a natural evolution of a protest. It was not. These were professionals.
Police also cleared the encampment that had been established on Columbia's lawn by student protesters. Columbia has asked the NYPD to have officers stay on campus through May 17th. That's 2 days after graduation. The lawyer allegedly behind hush money payment negotiations between Donald Trump and an adult film actress has testified that he believed the former president was behind the deal. Ira Spitzer reports from New York.
The jury at the court here in New York heard from a lawyer named Keith Davidson, who at one time represented adult film actress Stormy Daniels and the Playboy model Karen McDougal, another woman who said she had an affair with Trump. And while Davidson said he worked directly with Trump's former fixer, Michael Cohen, it was his understanding that Trump was the driving force behind the alleged $130,000 payment to Daniels, which forms the basis of prosecutors' election interference claims. The former president has denied all wrongdoing and has called the trial, which continues on Thursday, a sham.
Vice President Kamala Harris will promote reproductive rights in Florida today, the same day the state's six-week abortion ban takes effect. The Biden-Harris campaign says the vice president will be in Jacksonville to discuss what they see as harms that will be inflicted by the abortion ban. The U.S. and Mexico are taking joint action to slow the flow of illegal immigration at the border. More from Mark Mayfield.
In a phone conversation on Sunday, President Biden and Mexican President Obrador say they have committed to immediate measures to reduce these crossings. The exact measures are not being announced for now. Biden has reportedly weighed taking executive action at the border, but so far, no orders have been given. I'm Mark Mayfield.
Multiple newspaper outlets are suing Microsoft and OpenAI for copyright infringement. On Tuesday, eight newspapers owned by Alden Global Capital filed a lawsuit claiming Microsoft and OpenAI have used millions of their articles without permission to train their AI programs. The lawsuit also says these programs, such as ChatGPT and Copilot, have incorrectly attributed false reports to the newspapers, which they say tarnishes their reputation and spreads disinformation. And a quarter of American workers are worried that they may lose their job in the coming year. A survey by One Poll found that they're worried about the job market and the stability of their industry. Others are also worried about falling behind or lacking the skills needed for what they consider success.
WBSM Sports.
Red Sox beat the San Francisco Giants 4-0. Game 2 of a 3-game Fenway set tonight at 7:10. Bruins lost to the Maple Leafs 2-1 in Game 5. Game 6 Thursday in Toronto. The Celtics welcome the Miami Heat to TD Garden for Game 5 tonight at 7:30.
Now your ABC 6 South Coast forecast.
Starting off the day with cloudy skies, so we'll be seeing some sunshine this afternoon. In the meantime, this morning, those clouds or slight chance for some showers will taper off. Temperature in the upper 40s. This afternoon, some sun, upper 50s. Overnight, mostly cloudy, patchy fog, mid 40s. And then as we head into tomorrow, we'll be seeing a slight possibility for some AM showers. Turns mostly cloudy, low 60s. Be sure to watch ABC 6 for on my full 7-day forecast. From the ABC 6 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Cecil Carmen on New Bedford's News Talk Station 1420 WBSM.
This WBSM news update brought to you by Ocean Wine and Spirits Liquors. For the largest selection of nips near Fairhaven, now open at 157 Pope's Island in New Bedford. I'm Phil Devitt for WBSM News. Stay up to date with New Bedford's News Talk Station WBSM and get all of our content and breaking news alerts with the WBSM app.
Now maybe I did not mean to treat you bad, yeah, but I did it anyway. And then maybe some would say your life was sad, yeah, but you lived it anyway. And so maybe your friends will stand around you, watch you crumble as you fall to the ground. And then someday your friends will stand beside as you are flying. Oh, you are flying all so high. But then someday people look at you, they're what they call their own, they watch you suffer.
And welcome back in, 508-996-0500. You can also use App Chat on the WBSM app. Like DL in Dartmouth did. He says, with all the things going on in this world, we get to listen to you talk about a carnival for 3 days. You should have to listen to the last three shows as penance. Well, I'm glad you woke up on the right side of the bed, DL. This is actually a pretty big issue that's been generating a lot of discussion in the area. So sorry that it's not what you want to hear. You can go listen to something else if that's what you want to do. But I'm going to talk about the things that matter to people here on the South Coast. And it's one of the most read stories we've had in weeks. So going to guess that it is important to people. So again, you can go listen to something else. Come back at 9 for Chris. I'm not going to be offended. 508-996-0500. And speaking of the carnival, a few minutes ago, I did reach out to Fiesta Shows to ask if they wanted to come on to the program tomorrow and talk about some of these new policies. And they declined the invitation. So they are not going to come on and talk about this. So I guess we'll just have to kind of speculate a little bit too in the ways that these are going to be enforced. But this is something that people are upset about. Other people are really happy about it, but it is something that has been a major topic of discussion. And again, something that people are reading the stories about and responding to. So sorry, it's not what you want to hear. That's why the radio has a dial that can be moved from one station to another. Go check out some of the other stuff and then come back here when there's something on that you want to hear. 508-996-0500. Also, I mentioned this at the beginning of the program, but I want to remind those of you who want to have a chance to enter, because we are only accepting entries through the rest of this week, and then we'll move on to the next phase of this contest next week. But because Mother's Day is coming up, we are going to have our annual tradition of our mother-daughter look-alike contest. So we are accepting look-alike photos of mothers and daughters all week long. And then we're going to pick our favorite 100 over the weekend. Next week, we will publish our top 100 on Monday morning. And then it's your turn to vote. You, the audience, will pick the winner. You can scroll through all the photos and pick the best look-alikes on the South Coast. And then we will announce the grand prize winner the day after Mother's Day. And the prize package for the winning mother-daughter duo, it's huge. The lookalikes with the most votes will get a $1,000 Cardi's Furniture and Mattresses gift card, courtesy of Nairobi. They will also get $225 gift cards to Sister's Salon and Skincare in Mattapoisett, along with two $50 gift baskets packed with skin products. They'll also get two $75 Alianza restaurant gift cards. They will get treats from the Acai Spot in New Bedford. They'll get Mommy and Me bracelets from Corey Jewelers. and they will get gift cards to Mi Antojo Mexican Restaurant. So submit your photos now at WBSM.com and on the WBSM app. Because, again, we're going to be selecting the top 100 over the weekend. So you want to get those in by Friday. And, of course, this great mother-daughter look-alike photo contest is brought to you by Alianza, the SIE spot, Corey Jewelers, Mi Antojo Mexican Restaurant, Sister's Salon and Skincare, and Cardi's Furniture and Mattresses. So it's going to be fun seeing those entries. I've already seen some of them that have come in, and the bar is high. The bar is high. It's fun, too, to see some of the people who have entered in the past and say, oh, I remember them, and see as the children get older how much the resemblance stays the same or changes or increases. So if you know someone, even if you and your kids might not look alike, or, you know, a husband can nominate the wife, the dad can nominate the mom, the friends can nominate friends. Just make sure that, you know, they're okay with you putting pictures of their children on the internet, because all photos do become our property and allow us to put them on our site because you want people to vote for you, right? That's why you're entering. So just make sure that you're comfortable with your child's photo not only being out there, but also having people vote on it too. Some people are okay with sharing it, but they don't like the idea of it being voted on. So it's all part of the contest. All right, I'm going to take a break here. We'll be back in a few moments.
Oh, make me over. I'm all I want to be. A walking study in demonology. Hey, so glad you could make it. Yeah, now you really made it. Hey, so glad you could make it now. Oh, look at my
welcome back in, 508-996-0500, and you can use App Chat on the WBSM app. Some sad news that comes out of Providence. WPRI has the report that the Roger Williams Park Zoo is mourning the loss of one of its beloved goats. Gingy, who is a 10-year-old Nigerian dwarf goat, had to be humanely euthanized after suffering from age-related arthritis, which impacted his comfort, according to the zoo. So apparently this was one of the most beloved animals in the entire zoo, because it was part of the Alex Anani farmyard where kids could come and actually interact and play with the goat. And his favorite activities included being brushed, eating all the snacks, climbing up on staff to get scratches behind the ears, and sitting in the yard with the warm sun on his face. Gingy will truly be missed by all, the zoo said. And goats are actually, you know, from my understanding, I have friends who have goats. They say they're very intelligent creatures. They're very smart. They are very loyal. And that as, you know, as pets, they make very good pets. There was someone who posted in, I think it was one of the Facebook groups, I think it was All Things Plymouth, that they had a coworker. I guess it was their birthday or something, or they were celebrating an anniversary of being at the job, and they wanted to know if anybody had goats they could bring for that person to play with at work. And sure enough, somebody did. A local farm brought their goats, and they had a little goat party. I don't know. I mean, if anybody wants to bring goats down to the radio station, I'm sure we would like to have a goat party too. They used to actually bring animals from the zoo into Fun 107 pre-COVID. They would bring them in, and so you never knew like what animals were popping in to be here, which in some cases would freak certain people out, but, you know, it wasn't like they're not bringing lions in. There was also that story in Worcester a couple of days ago where a bear had been roaming around in the street and causing traffic disruptions. And as we've been talking about, the bears are, I guess, here now. Certainly out in the Worcester area, they're a little bit more prominent. But Mass Wildlife has finally said that bears are here in southeastern Massachusetts, and apparently they're here to stay. So you're going to see more of them wandering around. But I guess this bear in Worcester was causing some traffic issues. They had to, they couldn't get the bear to move along, so they had to sedate the bear. They put it on like a big mat, a big sheet, big, you know, carrying device, and hauled it off into somewhere where it was a little bit safer. But that this is the new reality that we have to live with. That if bears are here, you're going to have to learn kind of how to prevent them coming into your yard and what to do if you do encounter one. And as Mass Wildlife has been telling us, of course, if you do encounter one, turn around, walk away slowly. And if it's in your yard or if it's somewhere where you need to get it away from you, just make a lot of noise and the bear will turn around and the bear doesn't want to have to interact with you. It's more than happy to turn around and ignore you. And if you make a bunch of noise, the bear's going to look at you and say, "What's this idiot going on about? I'm going to go back in the woods." But the reason why they're going to come into your yard in the first place, outside of just, you know, passing through, is if you have food sources out for them. They've recently awoken from hibernation. They're hungry and they're looking for food. And they're looking for easy food because they're still a little groggy from that long sleep and they're not ready to hunt yet. And there's not a lot out there for them to hunt. The animals that they would normally eat, they're not, you know, for the most part, they're dealing with babies, and that's not going to fill them up. The fauna, the vegetation that they would normally eat, it's not ripe yet. It's not grown yet. So instead, they're looking for that easy food that you're leaving around. They're looking to go through your trash. They're looking for the bird seed that you leave out in a bag on the porch. They're looking for the dog food you leave in a bowl on the deck for when the dog's outside. That's the kind of stuff that they're going to eat. And then they're going to realize, oh, that's a place where I can go and get food, and they're going to come back. So Mass Wildlife suggests that you don't leave any food out, including bird seed. You take in your bird feeders and wait a little bit later in the season before you put them back out again. Although it's funny because it seems like Mass Wildlife is always telling us to get rid of bird feeders. Maybe they're just against bird feeders overall. But this is going to be the new reality. It's early yet. We're going to have more bear stories as they get into mating season next month. We're going to have more sightings. We're going to have more reports. We're going to have more encounters. And maybe we'll have to bring back the bear tracker like we did last year. But eventually it reaches the point where of do you need to have a bear tracker if there are already bears? We just get excited every time there's a bear because we know it's a fun story to talk about and we know it's something that people are interested in. But eventually it's going to become so common that it's not even worth mentioning anymore. But just be aware, be safe, and check out mass.gov for more information and more tips. Going to take a break here, my final break of the program for this morning. We'll be back in a few moments.
Finally, I figured out what it took a long, long time. Now there's a ton about me because I'm trying. There's been times it's all my road to leave you. I just can't turn and walk away. It's hard to say what it is I see in you. Wonder if I'll always be with you. Words can't say.
And welcome back in. We have a few moments remaining here before we're going to give way to Chris McCarthy and South Coast Now. And he will have Mayor Mitchell coming up in the 11 o'clock hour. They've got a lot to discuss. They will also have a lot of new information for you on some of the things that Chris has been talking about, including that retirement board open meeting violation. And, of course, I'll take your phone calls, 508-996-0500. I'll be back tomorrow. We'll talk more, although the carnival folks are not going to join me. We'll talk more about the carnival, mainly just because DL in Dartmouth doesn't want me to. And listen, that's the great thing about all the lineup of talk that we have here on WBSM is there's opportunities to talk about everything. If you're sitting around waiting because you want to complain about how the Trump trial is a sham and you want to complain about these punk kids at colleges, well, Barry's here for all.
What's the easiest choice you can make? Window instead of middle seat? Picking a vendor who sends a great gift basket? Outsourcing business tasks you hate? What about selling with Shopify? Whether you're selling a little or a lot, Shopify helps you do your thing, however you cha-ching. Shopify is the global commerce platform that helps you sell at every stage of your business. From the launch your online shop stage to the first real-life store stage, all the way to the did we just hit a million orders stage? Shopify's there to help you grow. Whether you're selling scented soap or offering outdoor outfits, Shopify helps you sell. Wherever and whatever you're selling, Shopify's got you covered. Sign up for a $1 per month trial period at shopify.com/try. Go to shopify.com/try now to grow your business, no matter what stage you're in. Shopify.com/try.